I won't.
Drop the ash.
I won't.
And let me.
Oh, it's damp.
Oh, you're welcome.
No, I mean, it's, I don't like it. Doesn't matter. I have to go soon.
No. I have to cook for you.
I can't eat two meals.
Yes, you can.
It gives me... It doesn't matter.
Ash! What did I tell you? No bloody ash. Oh, you pig.
Sorry. I'll get a brush.
Doesn't matter.
I have to go.
Do you know, I think you're putting on weight.
Don't start.
Okay, so you're not putting on weight. You're still as skinny as a chicken carcass. I can count those ribs from here.
It doesn't matter how much I eat. I burn it up. It's intellectual energy.
You need some proper feeding. A real woman's food. Something to plump you up.
I can't eat those, what you...
Tell you what, I can make you some polochinta with plum jam. That'll hardly fill you up at all.
But I'm not hungry.
That's no reason not to eat. Get dressed, you bag of bones. I'll fill you up with pancakes and dumplings till you burst.
I'm sorry, Gisella. I have to go.
I know you do.
But I won't. You look. You look.
Pancakes it is.
Keeping the Wolf Out. The Wolf by Philip Palmer.
Through here. The smell is...
Yeah. What do I need to know?
Yes, Investigator Lázár.
Are you new?
Not at all, comrade. Well, quite new.
How old are you?
When I got here, I got a call to...
Brisk up.
At 8:40 a.m, a man arrived at headquarters and said he'd found a dead body. He gave the address and a brief account, and it went to the sergeant. I accompanied the sergeant to the scene, namely, this alleyway. There was a dog. It was...
Faster and brisker.
A dog was consuming the remains. I tried to chase it off. I like dogs, but...
Hey.
The sergeant took out his gun and shot the dog. The street cleared, everyone just ran inside. It was extraordinary. I suppose they thought that...
Where does the alleyway lead?
To the boulevard, Bolivar Street. Erna's restaurant is on this side. The building on that side is a bank, which means access at the front, access at the back, and access from the restaurant, which has a door at the side. The body had been dumped behind some bins. The bins were full of food waste from the restaurant. There was a lot of blood. The face was chewed and the body had been beaten and burned.
What kind of burns?
Little dots. Cigarette burns. And red wheels. Maybe a poker? The wrists were bloody, but perhaps rope marks. He was stripped, tied up, beaten, burned, killed, then his body was dumped.
Good account. Is that your puke?
Yes. I turned my head. Chucked against the wall, not on the body in case of... Sorry.
Have you ever seen anything like this before?
Like what?
A man beaten, stripped, tortured, dumped. Have you ever seen that before?
No, comrade.
That tells me then.
Tells you what, comrade?
How young you are.
Here, take a taste.
No, I won't.
Go on, try it. You need filling out, Betsy. You're so skinny, I can count your ribs.
I wish you'd stop saying...
What? Stop saying what?
Nothing.
Tonight when we eat, you should actually eat. Don't just drink.
I'll eat.
Shin of lamb. It's a treat.
I can see the bone.
Don't just drink.
Are you saying I drink too much?
No. No, just don't only drink.
Not hungry, not after...
What?
I have to go out soon, an investigation.
10 minutes, that's all. Pour yourself some wine. Which investigation?
A police officer. A former... It's a murder investigation.
Was someone killed a cop?
Yes.
Have some more. You'll need it if it's a long night. It's ready now. Sit. Eat.
What is it?
Mrs. Kovac, I'm Investigator Lázár of the Budapest Police Department, Division 7. I want to...
Oh, is it about my son?
Yes, it is.
I know about my son. I've been told already. Goodbye.
No, I need to...
Goodbye. Leave. I need to
ask you some questions.
Why?
I need to find out who killed your
then
son.
Then find out. Go. Go out in the streets and find...
I'm sorry to have troubled you, Mrs. Kovac.
Wait. Through here. Sit. Sit. Don't make the place look untidy. What could I possibly know?
I've no idea. That's how it works.
How what works?
I don't know what you might know until I ask you.
Oh, you're one of those clever police officers. Not like my son, then. He could never spin a phrase like that.
Your son was...
I know what my son was. Not one of the clever ones.
The entire force is shocked. I promise you, we will find his killer.
They tortured him, didn't they?
Yes.
Ah. Oh.
Ah. You know something?
No.
About your son, what he did?
He was a police officer.
Before that?
He worked for the government.
He worked in Ondrashi Avenue. He was in the AVH.
Something like that.
You know what the AVH was?
It was a part of the government.
Not exactly. Your son was...
I know what my son was.
Then he left Ondrashi Avenue after the revolution, joined the police.
There was no revolution. No one calls it a revolution.
I stand corrected.
You hungry?
What?
Hungry.
Yes.
I have some stew.
Of course you do. Lamb?
I have a friend who's a butcher. My son had a friend, I should say. Yes, lamb. Onion, carrot, parsley root, noodles on the side. I can heat it up.
No, you stay there. I'll do it. Caraway seeds?
I have no caraway seeds.
So my mother swore by caraway seeds. Goulash was our Sunday meal. Every Sunday. We lived on a farm. We raised sheep, mutton goulash every Sunday, every Monday, every Tuesday sometimes. My mother was a great cook. And you know why? She was a cheerful cook. She let me eat from the stew dish and laugh. And by the time the meal came, we were all... Well, what can I say? It's what mothers do. They don't just cook. They make a meal into the family meal. You know what I mean? My dad was, well, let's not go there, but my mother was so cheerful. She could make a 10-week-old corpse crack a smile.
So why are you so skinny? No mother wants a skinny child.
That's because I think too much. And I pace. Here, behold me pacing. I walk 10 miles a day in my office pacing. That's why I never put on weight.
Oh, Mother, is she still alive?
Oh, yes. She lives in the country.
You visit, though?
Every Sunday.
A son should visit his mother.
Every Sunday. And she tells me stories of what happened on the farm. And my father, he sits in his chair drinking wine and snorting. He's not a talker, my father, but... You know he's listening because he snorts whenever he thinks what we're saying is trivial and stupid.
I know that type.
Men who disapprove of gossip.
I married that man. May he rest in peace. He was a sour-hearted, lazy, horse-faced son of a gypsy whore.
It's harsh words.
Oh, he wasn't so bad. There were worse.
I'm sorry. For the tragic loss of your son.
No, don't be. Ah, my life will be quieter alone.
What did you know about your son's work?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.